Well, yesterday I couldn't quite get together the Labor Day ripple that I had in mind. I just couldn't make it happen. And then I thought, well, you know, it's probably right under my nose. You know, this idea of Labor Day, and this year's Labor Day felt very different to me because, you know, since racism is front and center this year, as it should be, and hopefully remains so, I was thinking of all the unpaid labor that has been worked in this country, and I thought it might be a wonderful thing to do to put the Palace of Toil right up against the Palace of Toil, and just give thanks to all those who have produced and all those who actually continue to produce labor for which they're not acknowledged, labor which is not acknowledged, and labor for which there's no gratitude. And that's a pretty deep thing, especially in this country. And I'm wondering whether you think that would be a potent thing to do today. Yeah. You like it? Okay. So it's connecting two points, but bringing them together in you know, a state of prayer, but really gratitude. We use this as a motion of gratitude to close the work off and give gratitude. So the ripple that we'll be putting in the pond today is one of gratitude and one of prayer for those who have gone without being acknowledged. So thanks for being here. A bit somber today, but I don't think I didn't want to let Labor Day go by entirely without something like that. So thanks for being here. I'll leave the microphone on because there are some birds around.